In this video, we're going to take a look at the weather app on an iPhone with iOS 16. We're also going to compare this to an iPhone with iOS 15 so we can easily see the difference. On the surface, it may not look that different, but there's actually quite a few differences between them. So let's go over to my iPhones and take a look at the weather app. So I'm looking at the weather app. The one on the right is my iPhone with iOS 16. This is an iPhone 12 Max. The one on the left is my wife's phone, and that's still running iOS 15. I have the weather app open on both of them. It looks similar. If I swipe up, you're going to see that I have my daily forecasts. I have all of the different cards there. So not a lot of difference here. But let's go back up to the top on both of them. The first thing you may have noticed is the temperature is different. The one on the left running iOS 15 is getting its information from the Weather Channel. That's primarily where it gets its information. The one on the right, they incorporated dark sky in there quite a bit. There's the thunderstorm. So we can see that I'm having scattered thunderstorm, and you could probably hear it. But also you're going to see that in iOS 16, it's telling me that there is a beach hazard statement. We do not have that on the iPhone with iOS 15. So we're already getting more information. On top of that, when I swipe up, let's go ahead and swipe up on both of them here. When we're looking at these different cards, I call these different cards, we have here precipitation, sunset. I can see what the UV index is. These are all different cards of information. With iOS 15, I only can see the current information, which means if I wanted to get a forecast, maybe I'd like to see what the precipitation is for the week or maybe hour by hour. The only way that I could do that was by swiping up and then tapping on Weather Channel down towards the bottom. All of this information that I have on iOS 15 is basically just the current data. Well, with iOS 16, I can tap on any one of these cards to get hour-by-hour information as well as forecasted information. So let's go with precipitation. I tap on it. We can see a card opened up. I get my hour-by-hour, and what I'm able to do is swipe to get daily forecasts. I tap on the X. It brings me back. Let's take a look at that with feels like. Right now it feels like it's 84 degrees. Seems a little bit warm, but let's go ahead and tap on it. And now I can actually see an hour by hour for the humidity or the feels like temperature. And when I swipe over, I can see what it's going to be like for the rest of the week. Again, on the iPhone with iOS 15, the only way that I could get this information was by tapping on the Weather Channel down towards the bottom. It would open up the Weather Channel in Safari, and then I could see that information. Now I can see it all within the weather app. So on the surface, they may look similar, but we have a lot more information with iOS 16, and it is pulling information from different sources. So you may see a little difference in temperature there, as you're seeing here, 76 compared to 81. What else can we do with the weather app? Well, in addition to having those cards, we can also set the weather app to send us severe weather notifications for specific cities, as well as see the precipitation for specific cities. How do we do that? Well, we just go down to the three lines at the lower right-hand corner. When I tap on these, I can see all of the different cities. From here, what I need to do is go to the More button in the upper right-hand corner. When I tap on More, what you're going to see is notifications. So I tap on notifications, and from here what I can do is I can set if I want to receive severe weather alerts and next hour precipitation for specific cities. By default, what it's going to be set for is your current location. So you will always receive these by default, no matter where you are. But let's say you also wanted to receive them for another city. Maybe you have some family in another city, or you have a second house or a cabin or a cottage. You'd like to receive severe alerts for that city. Well, all we need to do is just go and select that city. My in-laws are located in Flushing, so I'm going to go to Flushing here. And now what I do is I just set if I want to receive severe weather alerts and if I want to receive next hour precipitation for this specific city for Flushing. So I would just turn these on. And now, even if I'm not in Flushing, if there's a severe weather alert, I will receive that. I will also receive next hour precipitation. So we can now set this up for individual cities here in the weather app. To add a new city, what we first need to do is go back over to all of our cities here, and then I can search for a city and I can add that. Once I add that, then I can go over to notifications here and set up my severe weather alert notifications. So that is what is new with the weather app on the iPhone with iOS 16. We have a lot more detailed information. And what we can do is we can set if we want to receive severe weather alerts, as well as next hour precipitation, for specific cities. So that's what's new with the weather app on the iPhone with iOS 16.